gorgeous day. Just got off the computer. That computer. And I got a bunch of topics you guys sent me on a status. I wrote that I was only going to put a status up for 10 to 15 minutes. And it's a quick, give me some topics you guys would like to listen to. And I was only expecting maybe one or two people to maybe catch me posting that in like 10 minutes before I shut it down. And then like 33 comments happened in like 5 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and keep that status open while out on this motovlog. That way, I can go read through the topics and try to cover as many as possible. Go, little kid. Shit. Hurry up. What the fuck are you doing? You guys are fucking stupid. Jesus Christ. Wow, kids are getting dumber and dumber, I think, man. See this crosswalk right here for kids? That's what there's a fucking here for. One topic I got was my opinion on if loud pipes save lives. Here's my answer to that. If you were in a car and I was coming up next to you, don't you think it would help if you heard this?
Yeah.
So, loud pipes do save lives because it helps you know who's around you. It makes the drivers around you aware that there's a motorcycle around them and it gets their attention. If they're drifting into you, you know, I like to give some throttle blips opposed to honking my horn. Because to me, the sound of an engine roaring really fast or really loud close to you, it gets people's attention. It scares them opposed to a little horn going honk, honk, like a little fucking piece of shit. So, I mean, I do recommend anybody that rides to get a pipe, no matter what it is you ride. Even if you ride a little 125cc supermoto or whatever. So I know a lot of you up in the UK area, you guys, I noticed like Spicy 110, for instance, he rides a 125 supermoto. Now, those aren't really common at all out here in America. Like those 125 street legal supermotos and whatnot. I mean, don't get me wrong, there's street legal 125s out there, but they're really few far and in between. Which actually sucks, because I do understand those are, you know, way cheaper than, you know, a bigger bike, but yet ridiculously fun. I wish to God we had them out here. Maybe I can order one from over there, have it shipped out here, I don't know. But I do know those Honda CT70s, those tiny mini trail bikes, those are street legal out here, and I could romp that around this city right here in these streets and go look for trails and go trail hunting and you know, enjoy myself, which is what I'm dying to do. I like little trail bikes. I know a regular size dirt bike would give you fun. I would like one, but I do like mini trail bikes, ones that are smaller, you know. It's just they're more versatile. And they're way easier to control in like situations where you're hitting ruts and whatnot. And you can just, you know, throw it and catch your body upright easier with your body weight and your strength. Alright, another topic I got was, what are my favorite bikes under 600cc? And they say favorite sport bikes, I believe. Now, you know, sport bikes, there's not a big selection. I mean, actually there is, but in America, there's not a lot of big selection for, you know, sport bike, actual sport bikes, like, you know, like a Ninja 300, you know, sport bike styling. There's not too many options like that besides knockoff Chinese bikes that you can run into here and there. But, and now as of a bike in general under 600cc, I like that, obviously the Yamaha WR250R. That is just one hell of a fucking bike. If I can take Ride Victoria's bike and just take it as is, that's exactly how I would like it. Just like his. He actually has my exact dream bike, you know. That's how I would like it. show you some apartments I lived in for quite a few years growing up as a kid. And they are ghetto with a capital G.
Yeah.
Maybe the gate's open so I can even drive in there so I can show you guys. Maybe my old friends live in there still. This is them right here. I lived right up there. Right now, my buddy told me that there was a guy that was shot and killed here a few like weeks ago or a month ago. They sell massive amounts of crack and cocaine out of here now. This place is just literal garbage. Like, there's like a backpack just chilling on the roof full of a bunch of random shit. Wait, what the fuck? I actually want to look at that. What is that? Is that trash or is that like a bag of like shit? Looks like it's got like gloves and tools in it. Why is that up there? Maybe somebody's building something up there. I always dream I come across a random bag of money, so hey. But yeah, guys, this is one place you would never want to live. This is just filth right here. And while living here, me and my friends made a Jackass type movie where we were doing a bunch of stunts and stuff. And we literally filmed for 6 months, if you can believe that. We actually kept that thing going, and we were, like, dedicated to it. And it was back with this old Sony handheld camera that took tapes. And there was a stunt I did where I was pushed in a shopping cart from the end of the street. It's really fast right here. And I was pushed into this fence. And to this day, see all this? All this opening right there, that was my body flew through there. And I landed on my head on the bottom down there, and my feet were just sticking up. So if you can imagine, think of being in a shopping cart from the end of the street right here, fucking hauling ass super fast from my like three people pushing you, smacking this bush, flying through the air and landing in here head first. That was what happened to me, and it was funnier than all fucking hell. If you guys saw the video, I still actually have the video to this day. It's one of those VHS tapes. I'll have to show it to you guys sometime when I did that stunt. It was so fucking hilarious looking. Fuck you staring at. But yeah, guys, that's one of the places I grew up in as a kid. Now this is like the only paved street in the whole city just because they built this brand new school right here. And why they built it right here, across the street from a cemetery in like one of the most ghettoest areas, and like there's people murdered at this lake all the time. Why they fucking built it here is beyond me. That dude's knocked the fuck out on the stairs. Uh-oh, there's a squirrel. Better not run in front of me, motherfucker. We're in downtown San Bernardino. Yeah! Like it's a hick town or something. Oh, look, there I am. Look, you're seeing yourself.
Yeah!
Oh. Lane splittity split split, girl, yeah. Well, look at that dude dancing on the corner. Oh my god, that's epic. Oh my god, that's fucking funny. I totally gotta fucking go over there and like get a better look at that. He's even singing. Vincent, one of my Chinese friends said, talk about that dickhead. I think he's just extremely gay. So I'm gonna go ahead and say something to you in your native tongue.
Like a somebody, fuck you, bitch.
There you go, buddy. How about maintenance for bikes from Cody? Sorry, buddy, I'm not like Garden Snake. I'm not a mechanic. I really can't really say much except keep your oil changed and always keep your chain checked and lubed. I mean, the average shit, guys. Keep your bike clean, cleaner than I do. All right, so we got pros and cons of smaller bikes, and we'll say in the 250cc and under range. Internal Revenue Service? Yeah, fuck the IRS. I'm gonna go try and do some parking lot exhaust while covering this. Alright. Pros and cons of a small bike is that, man, my bike sounds so beautiful in here. Now the pros and cons of a small bike is that a small bike, it's easy, you get the super good gas mileage, you get a way more lightweight machine. So, you know, it's easier for a beginner to handle, which is why they're beginner bikes, but for most of the time. I mean, most bikes are reliable with constant, you know, proper oil changes and maintenance, all the vital things. Woo! I just did a burnout. If you could see the shininess of the cement, it is as slippery as it looks, for sure. Let's see how beautiful it sounds in here. Aw, do not enter. Exhaust sound in a tunnel makes me feel like really excited. Makes me feel like all giggly inside. It's like exhaust sound. I bet you can hear that shit like a mile away. Uh-oh, security guard's coming. Do you know where the Me Gusta Dancing Studio is?
What?
Me Gusta Dancing Studio? It's around here? Have you heard of it?
Address?
It's not, I don't have an address. I heard it's by this parking structure, but I don't know where it's at. You never heard of Me Gusta Dancing Studio? All right, well thank you anyway, I'm gonna head out. And to get back to the pros and cons of the 250cc and under bikes, you know, really the cons, the only really cons of it is, you know, and it's not really important, but power deficiency, because me personally, it's not the most important thing, but me personally, I like having extra power at my disposal for, because I'm a person that I try to swerve around things and accelerate away from my problems opposed to slamming on brakes when situations happen, if you understand what I'm saying. So that being said, you know, having a smaller CC bike, it'd probably be a little harder to do something like that, which in my opinion is kind of a, not a bad default, but it's like, in my opinion, it'd be a default for me. But, you know, me having a smaller CC bike, I'm having the motherfucker to be doing some trail riding, so, and mostly off-roading, so I don't have to worry about that too much. But like I said, the advantages of the 250s is that you're gonna have like very cheap pricing, ridiculously cheap insurance and registration, very very cheap gas expenses for the month opposed to like a 600 or more. Oh, there's my buddy dancing. And overall, you know, when it comes to like a bigger bike now, always the cons or the advantages of a bigger bike are the power band. You got a lot more power to be used throughout the rev range. You got a lot more low end get up and go and torque opposed to a smaller bike. You don't really have to wind them out that much at all opposed to a smaller bike. And you know, if I'm riding like a long distance trip, I'd probably want to be on, you know, my 600 or, you know, a liter bike. If I'm doing like a 50 mile plus trip, just for comfort. And when you're traveling on the freeway, I can cruise in like 100, 120 if I really wanted to, you know, and still be in a low gear. You know, I'll still be low in my rev range. So That's more of an advantage for a bigger bike. You know, you got a lot more expandable power or expensible power. And that guy is still passed out on the fucking stairs. I'm gonna go see if he's at least okay, because I don't like seeing that shit. And he's in the same exact, his body's in the same exact position. Hey, bro. Hey, man, are you okay?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, because I passed by here, and you were in the same position I passed by, and I was just making sure you're all right. Yeah, all right, man. Take care. Yeah, I mean, in this city, people would drive by somebody on the ground that's, like, you know, maybe passed out, has a health problem, and they wouldn't even fucking bear to even worry about even picking up their phone and using their thumbs to dial the phone number to help them. Sadly. And let's go ahead and do today's Moto Vlogger Spotlight! And today's Moto Vlogger Spotlight for somebody with videos of quality. Great videos. Puts his time into his edits. Always uploading fucking great footage. A good moto vlogger, lots of videos. One of the supporters of my channel for a while as well. A great dude. Here's his commercial. Hope you guys liked it. Make sure to go subscribe to his channel to go enjoy more of his quality ass uploads. I personally love his channel a lot, and I'm sure he would love and appreciate all of you to stop by. Well, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up today. I don't want to make this video into an hour-long full-blown movie, so we'll go ahead and cover the rest of the topics up that I saw on another video, and go ahead and leave it at that. If you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to hit the fuck out of that like button, and you guys have a great day. Man, it seems like I'm always able to say fuck when there's someone walking right next to me to make them turn their head real fast. See you later, guys.